Welcome to the RPP Resonance Commission. I'm very happy to announce the new series of videos on wonderful textbook in organic chemistry. That is nothing but Jonathan Clyden. Okay, so this is very important textbook for any type of exam like a CSIR NET, GATE or IIT JAM, like BHU, CUSET, any type of competitive exams in chemistry. So this is the one of the best book for organic chemistry. Especially best book for organic chemistry, that is Jonathan Clyden. So simply here, Clyden book, this is the second edition. So here in case of CSIR exam, 40 to 60 marks in CSIR exam, 40 to 60 marks questions came from Clyden textbook only. So that is the probability of Clyden textbook questions. Okay, direct copy and paste questions they are given in the CSIR exam from Clyden textbook. So that's why I would like to choose these textbook explanation in series of videos based on their chapters. 43 chapters are there. Each chapter it takes a minimum 3 to 5 videos based on their content and depth of the topic. Okay, so now in 43 chapters, some of the unusual chapters are also there for competition, not the unusual for the chemistry. Okay, some of the unusual chapters for competition is there. That's why so I would like to choose the a continuation of videos from chapter 19 to 43. Okay, so before the 19, some of the useful topics are also there. So those topics I would like to explain in the middle of the this series. Okay, so 19 to 43, this is very conceptive and reactive topics. Okay, that's why I would like to start the 19th chapter in first video. Okay, so now chapter name, 19th chapter name, that is electrophilic addition to alkenes. Electrophilic addition to alkenes. This is the chapter number 19. Okay, so after watching the videos of organic chemistry series of videos, so you will get the definite idea. Okay, and you will learn some of the very simple trick regarding to the organic chemistry. Okay, you will watch the video until ending. Definitely, you will earn something regarding to the organic chemistry, and you will create interest on the organic chemistry. Okay. Now, don't waste our time, let's move on to the topic. So that is the electrophilic addition to alkenes. We know that electrophiles and nucleophiles. So if you have any doubts on electrophiles and nucleophiles, please watch my electrophile and nucleophilic classification video on GOC. Okay, simply bromine. So this is the brown colored liquid. So the bromine, so it is an electrophile, bromine having the one of the electrophile. So if bromine is electrophile, so bromine will treat it with any type of nucleophile, simply any type of nucleophile, BR. So it produces the nucleophile bromide and Br minus. This is an example of bromine act as electrophile. Now let's move on to the our topic, that is electrophilic addition to alkenes. So here it is the olefin, so which is treated with bromine, it is also produces the one of the type of a product, that is electrophilic addition product, that is the dihalo or dibromo alkene, dibromo ethane. Simply it is a dibromo ethane. So this example was explained by the molecular orbital as well as homo-lumo interactions of these pi bond and electrophile, nucleophile and electrophilic pi bonds. Electrophilic bonds. Okay, now let's move on to the very detailed analysis on electrophilic addition to alkenes. Electrophilic addition to alkenes. This is the nucleophile. Olefin is a nucleophile. So then undoubtedly, so bromine is electrophile. Bromine is electrophile. Now let's move on to the orbital orientation. So here it is the olefin. So it having the pi bond. So pi bond means it having the pi bonded electron cloud. So now here two energy levels. Why? Because it having the only two sp2 hybrid orbitals. So it having the two electrons. Those two electrons filled in the ground state. So this is the homo orbital. Okay. Now in similarly, bromine is electrophile. So electrophile having the only sigma bond. That means sigma and sigma star. So this is the antibonding. This is bonding. So here it having the bonded two electrons. So now here two electrons. Okay. So now here. Electrophile having the vacant orbital at the antibonding of sigma star, and the nucleophile having the pair of electrons at a psi 1, that is the ground state. It is nothing but a homo. So this is nothing but a lumo. So the homo and lumo interactions will give the formation of bromonium ion. So it was explained like this. So this is the olefin, hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. So this is the olefin bonding orbital. So this is simply HOMO. So now this is the like LUMO interaction. LUMO interaction. Okay. Now these two will produce the this type of cation. So this is the simple type of a bromonium cation. So the simplest representation of the above reaction is like this. So this is the olefin. So the olefin will treated with a BRBR, that is the like electrophile. The above nucleophilic reactions will explain it act as an electrophile. Okay. Now this is the olefin. Okay. So this is the olefin. This olefin will shift it towards the like their pi bonded electrons towards one carbon atom, and it becomes a minus and a positive. Okay, those minus will attack over the like Br plus, and it is eliminated as Br minus. Okay, now it produces the Br plus. This is the primary carbocation. So here the primary carbocation is very unstable. So due to the instability of primary carbocation, the lone pair of bromine electrons will attack over there, and it forms the like these type of like bromine cation, this type of bromine cation. So this is the wonderful representation regarding to the bromonium. So this is very unstable representation. This is very unstable representation due to the like understanding of the reaction. I would like to explain the very complete steps which are involved in the like these electrophilic addition to olefins. Okay. Now here the curly arrow representation of alkene like this. The bonded two electrons will shift towards the bromine atom, and it creates the bromonium ion. So those bromonium ion which was like a three membered ring. So this is the three membered ring. It is very like a highly steric crowding ring, very highly steric crowding ring that is ready to open it, So the bromide ion, so which participated in the like a SN2 type of reaction, now it produces the like a dibromo alkane. Okay, now the bromonium orbital also like this. This is the bromine. So now here it is the like vacant orbital of bromine. So bromide ion is a filled pair of electrons. That means it is the like a HOMO. So the HOMO of bromide ion and the LUMO of one of the carbon bromide sigma bond, sigma antibonding. Okay. Now here it is the one of the carbon bromine sigma bond is there. Those sigma antibonding of any one of the carbon bromide, either left side or right side, so which accept the pair of electrons from bromide ion, and it forms the this type of trans alkane, like this type of not the trans, so opposite like anti dihalogenated alkane, anti dihalogenated alkane. This is the very basic reactions. Now let's move on to the very interesting reactions, that is the oxidation on alkenes to form as epoxides, to form epoxides. Okay, now, so that is oxidation of alkenes. Oxidation of alkenes to form epoxide. So the simplest representation of epoxide formation. So in the presence of nascent oxygen, so it produces like this type of three-membered heterocyclic. We know that this is the epoxide. So this is the like a oxygen. So this is the like tetrahydrofuran. Okay, so this is simply, it is called as oxyrhein. So oxyrhein, oxygen, like a tetrahydrofuran, THF. Okay, so these are the like a heterocyclic, mono heterocyclic derivatives. Okay, now here it forms the like oxyrhein, that is nothing but epoxide, Now olefin, those are the nucleophiles. So those nucleophiles will attack over the like nascent oxygen, which act as a electrophile, so it forms the epoxide. So now which type of reagents will produce the nascent oxygen, that is the main criteria. Okay, so generally peroxy acids are the best source for the nascent oxygen. So this is the one of the best reagents. So the peroxy acids is nothing but this is the carboxylic acid. Now we know that this is the carboxylic acid. So the carboxylic acid having the like peroxy linkage, those are called as peroxy acid. So now we have the many more number of peroxy acids. So the best peroxy acid is nothing but like this is the benzoic acid. So benzoic peroxy acid, peroxy benzoic acid, which having the meta position as a chlorine. So metachloro peroxy benzoic acid, simply it is called as a metachloro perbenzoic acid. So metachloro perbenzoic acid. So this is the like MCPBA, the best reagent. So now instead of chlorine, we would like to take the NO2. It is better to use it for the like a spiro epoxide formation, spiro compound epoxide formation. This is a MNPBA. These are the best peroxy acids. Not only these, so some of the like CF3COOOH. So these are the like a trifluoroperoxy acid. These are the best peroxy acids which produces the nascent oxygen. Now, how do you prepare the peroxy acid? So simply any peroxy acid which can prepare from the like anhydride in the presence of H2O2, it produces the peroxy acid. The best example like a trifluoroacetic anhydride in the presence of like a strong H2O2, it produces CF3COOH, again CF3COOH. Here the carboxylic acid, trifluorocarboxylic acid, simply carboxylic acid as a best living group. That's why it readily forms the CF3COOH more than 85%. These are the like peroxy acid reagents. Not only peroxy acid reagents, sometimes like DMDO. So very like huge moieties, like DNA structure, DNA enzymated molecules, olefins, DNA enzymated molecular olefination, it requires some more sensitivity. That's why here we use the DMDO. So those DMDO is nothing but like dimethyl dioxirane. So simply it is the structure of dimethyl dioxirane like this. So here it is also produces the like nascent oxygen. Not only this, like some of the alkyl peroxides as well as H2O2, which are also produces the nascent oxygen. But we don't want to go for the those detailed analysis. We did not cross over the our topic boundary. So that's why I would like to explain these two peroxy acids only in this chapter. Okay, now let's move on to the mechanism of the like peroxy acid epoxide formation. Peroxy acid epoxide formation. Okay, now epoxide formation. So this is the olefin R, simply it is a RR. Okay, now here it is the like peroxy acid. Okay, now it involves the more steps. So now I would like to explain each and every step very easier. So this is the olefin. The pi bonded electrons attack over the electrophile. Similarly, alkene attack over the bromine electrophile. Okay, now here it is the deficient atom. So the deficient atom which is attacked by the like more electronically rich species, then the bond one of the weaker bond, it lost their weaker bond. So here oxygen peroxy linkage is very weaker. So that's why it lost their peroxy linkage bond towards the carbon oxygen single bond, and it makes as carbon oxygen double bond. Now here carbon exceeds its counter, that's why the bonded two electrons will shift towards the oxygen atom. So this is very interesting like a concerted reaction mechanism. So then it becomes a O-. Those O- will obstruct the proton and it creates the OH. Then the bonded two electrons between the OH, the bonded two electrons will shift towards the positive of the olefin. So this is the first one, second, third, fourth, fifth. It follows the five steps. So simply it appears the like this type of transition state R. So now here like a making and breaking bonds will seems to be like a dotted one. So here it is the hydrogen, oxygen, like a carbon, oxygen. This is the one. Now here it is the R. So this is the simplest transition state of peroxy acid formation, like peroxy acid with alkene reaction. Okay, now based on this, here the alkene which is attacked by the just only nascent oxygen, how it produces the this type of olefin, and as usually RCOOH, that is the acid. Like simply whatever the R group is taken, those corresponding acid was obtained. Okay, this is the very simplest reaction mechanism regarding to the epoxide formation. Now let's move on to the some of the stereospecificity and the rate of reaction towards the epoxidation, as well as stereochemistry of olefins epoxide formation. Now let's move on to the some of the examples. So the first example, so this is the like a cycloalkene which is treated with MCPBA. We know that what is the MCPBA? Metachloroperoxybenzoic acid. So now it produces the olefin on like epoxide and alkene, epoxide and cycloalkene. So this is the simplest example. So now some of the stereospecific reactions are also there. Stereospecific. So the stereospecificity of any type of olefin which was reflected on the geometry of alkene. So stereochemistry was reflected on the geometry of alkene. Why? Because so epoxidation takes place at either above the plane or below the plane, same phase. It takes place on the same place, same phase. So now here, that's why the geometry of alkene as usually reflected on the product. Okay, simply here it is this cis compound. So this is the like an example of a cis-stilbene. So this is cis-stilbene which treated with the MCPBA. Now it produces the like this type of epoxide. It produces the this type of epoxide. Now here it is the like a cis compound. This is the cis olefin. That means here it is the like above the plane. Here also above the plane. Cis epoxide. So instead of cis olefin, we would like to take the like a trans stilbene. Trans stilbene. Now we will get the like a trans as a major product. Trans as a like major product. This is the like a trans product. This is the above the plane, below the plane. The stereochemistry of epoxide as usually reflected on the geometry of olefin. Geometry of olefin. So now let us discuss the like some of the rates of reaction towards the epoxidation with the MCPBA. Towards the epoxidation with the MCPBA. Now in generally, so this is the a simplest reaction. So it is the olefin R1, R2, R3, R4. Okay, this is the olefin which is treated with any MCPBA, any peroxy acid. Now we produces this type of olefin R1, R2, R3, R4. This is the olefin. So now in case of like different substituents, which one readily reacts or which one more reactive towards the epoxidation? So this is the like tetra substituted olefin. So that indicates here it is surrounded by the more number of alkyl groups, that is the plus I groups. So the plus I groups which increases the like electron density on the pi electrons, that increases overall nucleophilicity of olefin. So due to that more nucleophilicity, it readily undergoes the epoxidation. That's why like a tetra substituted is more reactive towards the epoxidation, like rather than the tri-substituted. Tri-substituted is also more than that of the like like same carbon disubstituted, which is greater than that of the di like a different carbon atom substituted. Now it is mono substituted. Finally olefin. This is the 650 times like it is more reactive to than that of the general olefin. So this is the simple reactivity order towards the olefins. Now some of the regioselectivity is also there. Regioselectivity of epoxidation. So now here it is the like derivative. So one of olefin is there, that is the disubstituted olefin. Another olefin is a tetra substituted olefin. So now they are given in the like a very equivalent compound, a very like a calculated one equivalent of MCPBA. Now what is the result? So now either epoxidation takes place or epoxidized takes place at tetra substitution or disubstitution. So that is the here it having the two potential positions, but it having the only one equivalent. So rather than the one position, it attack over the like a specific position, that is called regioselectivity. So now here tetra substitution is more reactive. That's why tetra substitution gets epoxide. So this is the regioselectivity of epoxide. Now in case of a similar diene monoepoxidation, it requires any one of the like olefin gets epoxidized in presence of buffer solution. Okay, in presence of buffer conditions. Now let's move on to some of the examples regarding to the DMDO. So this is very simple reactions. Now let's move on to some of the examples regarding to the DM. So now before going to the DMDO, let's discuss the like a spiro compound formation. So now in presence of metanitroperbenzoic acid, so now it produces the this type of olefin epoxide, spiro compound. So spiro compound is nothing but two rings joined together at a single carbon atom. This is simply, it is known as a spiro compound. This is the spiro compounds. So this is the more than one common carbon centers are there, then it is a fused one. Okay, now this is the spiro compound. Spiro compound, in presence of meta nitro carbenzoic acid, is better reagent. Okay, now DMDO. So this is the dimethyl dioxyrene, which is prepared from the carbonyl in presence of KHSO5. It produces the KHSO5. It produces the dimethyl dioxyrene. So this dimethyl dioxyrene will treat it with olefin. So it is very reactive compound. So this is the derivative. So now one of the olefin pi bonded 2 electrons will shift towards the oxygen atom. Now it gets the O minus. So this is the oxygen. The pair of lone pair of electrons from oxygen will attack over the positive charge of the olefin, and it creates the this is the bond. Now it creates the positive charge on the oxygen atom, and it is O minus. Those O minus will shift towards the carbon oxygen single bond, and it makes carbon oxygen double bond. The bonded two electrons will shift towards the oxygen atom, and it becomes neutral. So this is the epoxide, and it is the carbonyl compound. Now we will get our old product as usual. So this is the better advantage for the DNA structures. It is unaffected on the many of the functional groups. That's why American scientists, they are worked together with DNA molecule structures. Now I'll show you one of the example regarding to this DNA structure. I think it is very helpful for you guys. Okay, so this is the initiative video on series of lectures on Jonathan Clyde textbook. I think it is very helpful for you guys. Thank you so much for watching.